what role does money play in all of this? Is money a huge influence in politics, super PACs, all that kind of stuff? Or is this more just kind of a narrative that we play with? Because from the outsider's perspective, it seems to have, that seems to be one of the fundamental problems with modern politics.
So I was just having this conversation, Marshall Kosloff, my co-host on The Realignment. And it's funny because if you do enough research, we actually live in the least corrupt age in American campaign finance, as in it's never been more transparent. Mm-hmm. It's never been more up to the FEC and all of that. If you go back and read, not even 50 years ago, we're talking about Lyndon B. Johnson handing people, like literally he came up in his youth, paying people for votes, like the boss of the, you know, the person who like had all the Mexican votes, like the person who had, and he was like giving out briefcases. This is it, like within people's lifetimes who are alive in America. So that doesn't happen anymore. But I don't like to blame everything on money, although I do think money is obviously a huge part of the problem. I actually look at it in terms of distribution, which is that how is money distributed within our society? Because I firmly believe that politics, this is going to get complicated, but I think politics is mostly downstream from culture. And culture, obviously, I'm using economics because there's obviously a huge interplay there. But like in terms of the equitable or lack of equitable distribution of money within our politics, what we're really pissed off about is we're like, our politics only seems to work for the people who have money. Mm-hmm. I think that's largely true. I think that the reason why things worked differently in the past is because our economy was structured in different ways. And there's a reason that our politics today are very analogous to the last Gilded Age, because we had very similar levels of economic distribution and cultural problems too at the same time. I don't want to erase that, because I actually think that's what's driving all of our politics right now.
So that's interesting. So in that sense, representative government is doing a pretty good job of representing the state of culture and the people and so on. Yeah.